Welcome to the winds and air pressure lab prep video. The first part is where you're gonna go out to your weather station and record data for the seven weather elements like you have been. But you're also gonna be measuring wind speed. This is kind of the new thing this week we're adding. So this is the wind gauge that you're gonna be using outside at your weather station. What we have is a ping pong ball that as the wind blows will hopefully move up and down here. In the wind, you got the fishing line that's attached to this little star up here. So make sure that you're threading it right through that point. And you see we've got these numbers going from zero, no wind, all the way up to about 50. And this is all going to be in kph, which is kilometers per hour. So you'll print off the sheet, laminate it, and if it hasn't already been done for you. And then you're going to attach it to like maybe a straw. In this case, you've got a little piece of metal. A part of a straw, and then you'll take a bamboo skewer. It's going to go up into the straw so that this can freely rotate around to get your wind direction. So for this portion of the lab, you're going to head out to your weather station to take some wind speed and wind direction measurements. So the first thing you need to do is find which way is north. You can use a compass or your iPhones. And then you need to have one person assigned to hold the apparatus. And then another person is going to be in charge of the time, so timing every 30 seconds for 15 minutes. And that way you can get a whole bunch of different measurements of the wind speed and wind direction. So as we're standing here, the wind's blowing a teeny little bit, and so we can see this white portion moving around with the wind. So that's going to tell you the wind direction. And remember, the wind direction is the way the wind is coming from, not going to. And then another person is going to be in charge of watching this ping pong ball and where that fishing line is pointing to on the actual wind speed portion of the apparatus. So you'll make sure to have somebody to record all this information as well. And then once you have everything, come on inside and then record everything onto your wind rose diagram. The second part of this has to do with the online media. So follow the directions in your lab to determine the wind speed and direction of each of these different locations. If you have questions about the material, see the lecture videos. I go into it in a lot of detail in those. So if you have questions, please email me with any questions or concerns.